Hello, my name's Forrest. Forrest Gump. What are you doing?
I got a problem on the Watergate scandal. It's due tomorrow.
I know just about everything there is to know about that.
Well, then could you help me, Mr. Gump?
Well, sure. This is the Watergate affair, in plain English.
Well, the year was 1972. The date was June 17th, to be exact. On this day, a strange thing happened at the Watergate office complex in Washington, D.C. At the time, it was the home of the Democratic National Committee. I saw the entire thing from my hotel room. I saw five men sneaking around in the complex that night, after everything had been all locked up. Now, I don't know much about politics, but I hear that these men was Republicans, but whatever that may mean. Their names were Bernard Barker, Virgilio Gonzalez, Eugenio Martinez, Frank Sturgis, and James W. McCord, Jr. Things began to happen after the break-in. The current president of the United States was a well-off fellow by the name of Richard Nixon. As the days went by, Nixon's friend was accused of being criminals. Evidence began to accumulate against the staff and Nixon himself. Apparently, Nixon was found to be personally involved in paying hush money to the five burglars, so they would keep quiet. Eventually, the people found out that Nixon had recorded conversations surrounding Watergate and that he had lied about not being part of it many times. During the time around the burglary, Nixon had the Oval Office wired so that he could keep recording conversations on tapes, and the government and public eventually pressured him into turning them over. But it was found that some of them had been destroyed, and others had been tampered with. One of the recordings had an 18-minute long gap of silence. Now, if you ask me, he was a very smart man. One tape recorded on June 23, 1972, turned out to be pivotal in finding Nixon guilty. This tape provided the smoking gun against Nixon. He soon faced impeachment due to obstruction of justice, abuse of power, and contempt of Congress.
You're fired!
Before you could say Bubba Gump, Richard Nixon resigned on national television on August 8, 1974. It is now considered one of the greatest scandals in American history.
Yo, man, Mr. Gump, man, you're so smart. You must be a genius, man. You must have an IQ of 160. Yo, man, yo, you cool, man. It's just... Hey, the real, I'm gonna see if you gotta come home. Tell mama I ain't coming home until I'm done with my project, man. I'm talking to Mr. Gump. I'm having a conversation with the legendary ping pong champion himself, man. Why don't you go ahead home? Tell mama I want some hot dogs and some waffle fries for my dinner, and I'll be home in like 30 seconds. You know what I'm saying?